So to set us up, we have two functions here. We have P of x and Q of x. They're both in vertex form. So who can tell me what they know is the same about these, since they're both in vertex form? Well, something that's popping that's the same. Lily? I just can't hear.
She said she's sorry, she's confused.
Oh, I just want to know what's the same about these. So they're both in vertex form, which tells us what's the same between the two functions, P of x and Q of x. Well, they both do have a y-intercept. What about the form, in vertex form, what should pop out at us? What piece of information? Vertex form. It's in the name, vertex. Yep, so the y value of the vertex is 10 for both. That's true. Okay. Troy? Okay. So that's a difference, but I'm saying, like, what do we know is the same between the two? So we're going to get there in a second. They have the same vertex. We know they have the same vertex because in vertex form, here's my white ink. Here's my 4, right? And here's my 4 for my x value of my vertex, and here's my 10. Here's my 10. So 4, 10. And it is given to you on your graph right there, 4, 10. What's different? Troy pointed out one thing. One's positive, one's negative, which we know things about that. And then what else is different? Sean?
One one's like narrower than the other.
Yeah, which one's narrower?
The left one.
Yeah, P of x. That's got a negative 1 in front, and this has a 1/2. Okay, so there's lots of stuff we already know. What I want you to focus on is graphing P of x. All right, you're already given the vertex, and you're given the y-intercept. Let's say they didn't give you the y-intercept. What would we do to find the y-intercept? And don't overthink it. It worked for lines. It's worked for everything we've done. Okay? Yeah, the y-intercept happens when x is 0. So even though it's given, you wouldn't even need it given. You would just plug 0 in for x, and you would get negative 6 for y. Okay? It's given, but you wouldn't even need it. The y-intercept always happens when x is 0, just like the x-intercept always happens when y is 0. All right, so I want you to look for at least 2 more points. At least 2 more points. So this says find the coordinates of another point. I want 2 more points. So looking at the graph of P of x, I'm hoping that the point that's popping to you is 8, negative 6. And who can tell me how we know just by looking that this has to be a point? Ivy? Yeah. Every time we've seen this up and down thing, there's like a corresponding point that is a mirror image across the axis of symmetry. So then we need to get another point. I heard people slinging all kinds of little x values. I chose to go with 2 when I've done it today. So I'm going to substitute in 2. And so run through these order of operations with me. I get 2 minus 4 is negative 2. Squared is 4. The opposite of 4 is negative 4. Plus 10 is 6. So I have 0.26 right here. And I'm a big fan of writing my ordered pairs on the graph. It really helps me visually just know what's up. And then I've got a mirrored image over here at 6 then, because I know that the axis of symmetry splits my parabola exactly in half, and I get a mirror image on both sides. All right? So the big idea here is, if I know one point on one side of my axis of symmetry, I automatically know another one. And some things that people will do is, like, do you see how, like, maybe you consider using negative 2 as an input? If you know that negative 2 is 6 away from the axis of symmetry, someone might choose to use 10 as an input instead. No, it's going to be the same output. So there's some choice you can have with negatives and positives here. So next, knowing what you know now, I want you to try to graph Q of x. I'm going to give you the hard, the hardest point. You ready for this? So you're going to graph Q of X now. Okay, the vertex is right here at 410. I'll give you that one. All right. Let's go. What's a good, easy one usually to find first, do you think? I'd say the y-intercept. Yeah. The y-intercept happens when x is 0. That's what I would go for first. But I want you to get two different points. So who can help me find the y-intercept? That's the one I want first. How am I going to do that, Brendan?
So you put 0 in
for
x.
Yeah, I'm going to do q of 0. And everybody's going to help me with these order of operations. So 0 minus 4 is?
-4.
-4. Square it?
16.
Half of that?
8.
Plus 10?
18.
So 0, 18 has to be one of my points. And I know if I have 0, 18, what other point do I already know?
8, 18.
8, 18 is the same distance away. Okay, now, something I'm going to notice is, do you see how there's that 1/2 in front? So a pretty common thing I like to try to use, a number that's nice to work with, is 1. However, I know if I put 1 in, I'm going to have an odd number that I'm dividing by, and then it won't be quite as nice. Do you guys see how I'm like thinking ahead a little bit? So instead of using 1 as another input, I'm going to choose to use 2. Still a small number, but if I use 1, I was going to get a half, and I'm going to try to avoid the half. So everybody help me with my order of operations. 2 minus 4?
-2.
Square it?
4.
Divided by 2?
2.
Plus 10? 12. You can use a calculator, but I think you're more likely to make a mistake than just add, subtract, multiply, and divide. And then 6, 12. Okay. I'm just saying, I probably did it just as fast as you did on a calculator, going slow and having you answer it. Like, where you should just be able to look at that and rattle those things off. Boom, 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 boom. Yeah. All right, there we go. So the big idea here is that any input pumps out an output, right? Any input that's a real number. Once we know one output that isn't the vertex, we automatically know the other that's equidistant away from the axis of symmetry, right? We understand the reflective nature of the axis of symmetry. And then we're still looking at those things like how narrow or wide it is and which direction it points, up or down. Now, with the up or down in mind, right, if we've been talking about a minimum or maximum a bit, so check out problem number 3 here. Priya says she can look at the function or the situation and immediately know if the vertex is a maximum or minimum. So I want you to know your experience making those graphs and this little table to prove why Priya is right or wrong. Closed, please. So I'm going to input 3, which is opposite of 3 minus 4 squared plus 10. So help me with my order of operations again. 3 minus 4?
-1.
Square it.
1.
Opposite of that?
-1.
Plus 10?
9.
And we just established if they're both 1 away from the axis of symmetry, it has to be the same, right? So are you guys seeing this goes up and then down? Which means the vertex here has to be what? The maximum or the minimum? Max. Also, I know it has to be the maximum because the negative in front here tells me that my parabola opens down. So this is what I'm looking for to know which way it opens myself instead of input-output. But they both prove it, right? We know that there's the same answer twice in a lot of situations. The cannonballs that shoot, right? Those had the negative 16t squared, which can be written as negative 16t times t. Okay. Cool. Next up, you guys are going to do some matching. You're going to be given cards with functions and with graphs on them. It's your job to match them. Document it in your notes on the next page, and then write how you know that they are the match, okay? All right, so trying to get this so you can kind of see my process. Uh-oh, where is it? There it is. So, as I see this, here's my process. And we'll maybe just kind of verbally do the matches maybe after this. I started myself with the graph, and I looked for the vertex, and I noticed that the vertex was 4, 1, which tells me that in vertex form, I need an x minus 4 in my parentheses and a plus 1. So my options, so I need an x minus 4 and a plus 1. My options for our cards were the opposite of x minus 4 squared plus 1. Or 2 times x minus 4 squared plus 1. So those were my two options with that vertex for 1 in my cards. So how did I choose the correct one of the two with the correct vertex? How can I decide which one? So they both have the correct vertex. Nobody can tell me how to decide. Josiah?
Oh, like the times 2 would make it open upwards.
Yeah. This one has to make it open up, right? So the other card with a vertex of 4, 1 by the graph. Let's see if I can find a quick shuffling. Is graph C. Are you guys seeing graph C? Okay. I'll try to get that on here too. Where? I can't find it. There it is. So graph C also has a vertex of 4, 1. But since it opens down, I know that that has to be the g of x version, which is the opposite of x minus 4 squared plus 1. And I essentially did that with all of them. So just for the video, I'm going to pause the video or end the video, but we'll go through the rest as a whole class. So really, I looked for the vertex. For all these, I looked for the vertex and then plus or minus for opening up or down. That's how I told the difference between everything.